Since the beginning, we've been wondering about our location in the cosmos. The story began when we knew that we are not the center of the universe. Few hundred years ago, flying beyond the horizon high enough to escape our planet was just a dream or maybe a fantasy. That dream had become reality when we understood some laws of the universe. So, how much does it take to escape our planet Earth? In the 17th century, Sir Isaac Newton developed the theory that explained why objects fall, like apples from trees, and other objects don't, such as the moon. It's due to one of the fundamental forces in the universe called gravity. So what is gravity? Gravity, according to Newton, is the force that attracts objects to each other, or massive objects to each other. But Einstein has a different meaning for gravity. He describes it as the distortion of space-time caused by the presence of matter or energy. Few hundreds of years later, after Newton's theory of gravity was published, the world found out it's actually wrong. Not too wrong, but wrong. Here is why. The theory proved to be incapable to calculate the force of gravity in very sensitive gravitational situations. In other hands, general theory of relativity developed by Albert Einstein has surmounted Newton's theoretical limitations. But we still use Newton's theory of gravity because it works fine and simple. Newton not only discovered why objects fall, but also how they do fall. He invented calculus, allowing us to calculate the force of gravity for any objects in the universe, which leads us to predict the motion of any celestial objects, like a planets around the star or moons around the planets, starting with our moon that is falling but never falls. Based on Newton's first law of motion inertia, an object in motion stays in motion at the same speed and direction while it isn't affected by an external force. The force of gravity applied by Earth on the moon affects its direction and somehow the speed too. Let's imagine that this ball is the moon and I am planet Earth. I start pulling the ball while it's orbiting me at a certain speed and distance. If the force applied by me on the ball gets stronger, it can approach me and maybe touch me. If the force applied by me on the ball gets weaker, it can escape me. So, how can we escape this gravity prison? According to Newton's second law of motion, force equals mass times acceleration. Thus, to escape this gravity prison, we need to accelerate an object. In other words, we need to give it a force stronger than the force of gravity, until it gets far from the strong gravitational field of Earth with a certain speed. The more massive an object is, the more force we need to pull it up. To do this operation, we need to build a negative potential energy repaying machine, or a rocket. Newton's third law of motion says, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Let's imagine that this balloon is a rocket. When a rocket moves up, the energy inside it gets out, so it gets pulled up. It's somehow the same concept when you jump. You can't jump without pulling the ground down. The force applied by you on the ground when you jump equal to the force that gets you off the ground.